Teams for tonight's game, starting with the London Towers, and David Lindstrom in charge now for a week, and he's had a few days practice with his team, which is more than he had going into his first three games. The blow for him tonight, Terrell Myers, he has suited up, but is not expected to play, a quad injury sidelining in Myers. They don't want to risk him ahead of their big games at the weekend. And the visitors, Ulkaspor of Istanbul in Turkey, had a big win last weekend in the EuroLeague with a victory away from home against Peristeri of Greece. That has put them very much in the running for a top four finish and qualifications. There's the starting five for the London Towers. No space for Terrell Myers as Silas Chung will join Brett Eppenheimer and John White in the backcourt. Hickey and Phil Kent up front. It's the starting five for Ulka, one man to keep an eye on, Erdene, who had 34 points in their win against Peristeri last week. Eli and Lollis, the two Americans, also will be a handful for the Towers. Phil Hickey then lines up alongside William Ellie for the jump ball. The London Towers will come down with the first offense of the game in the shape of Eppenheimer. Kent trying to get it inside, bailed out by John White after the ball was knocked loose. Eppenheimer. Eppenheimer with the pull-up, lot resting on Brock Eppenheimer's shoulders tonight with the absence of Terrell Myers. There's Lollis, has Erdene behind him and finds the veteran Turk, Akic. Lobbed inside but broken up by John White. Silas Chung comes up with it. Chung back to Eppenheimer. Eppenheimer for three off the back of the ring, but it comes all the way out to Silas Chung. He lobbed it in. That almost went in for Silas Chung. He tried to lob it in to Jeff Kent. The ball almost dropped for him. Achik. Achik to the basket. Nice move. Not quite enough on the lay on Phil Hickey. Pulls down the board and away comes Eppenheimer. Forced to reset. Eppenheimer. Be interesting to see if Towers break down on any of their offenses. They're bound to have a few new plays with the new coach now fully ensconced. That one didn't quite look on that play like they hadn't quite worked out exactly what they were doing on the new offense. It was a little bit labored, and in the end Eppenheimer decided to go it alone and just sent one of them. He bounced off his toes. Ellie for the Turks to Erdene. Has Lollis on the post. Lollis backing down on Ken. Big strong move from Quadre Lollis. First score of the game for Ulka. 2 minutes in. Hickey to Chung for three. That one rims out. Lollis with the rebound. Achic. Achic running to the hole. Doesn't get anything on the lane, but the whistle was called first. The foul is the first of the game, and it's on Brett Eppenheimer. Here's another look. Good change of pace from Achic going to the basket. He has looked quick in the opening couple of plays, attacking the basket. Quite remarkably for a EuroLeague team, there's a lot of home nationals in the Ulka side. No fewer than seven Turks. White trying to get it inside. Good hands from Lollis to break it up. Erdene comes up with the loose ball. He kicks forward to Golovic. Backs out for three. The three doesn't go. Lollis going after the rebound. Tips it up in the air, but Kent beat him to it. And Chung came down with it. Chung pull up, towed the line. That one is short. Ellie with the rebound. Coach Didin off puff his seat there to tell his point guard to slow down a second. Let's get into an offense. The way off the mark. That wasn't what the coach told him to do. And the coach turned around straight away to Akic and said, what are you doing on that? What sort of shot was that? There he is, still chatting away. Chung to Kent and Hickey. Big men a long way from the basket for the London Towers. Eppenheimer, deep three from way out. Brett Eppenheimer, 4 or 5 feet behind the line. He has all five of the Towers' points. Erdene. Still Erdene. Erdene with a tough pull-up three, doesn't go. Lawless with the offensive board and stick back. He draws the foul as well. Just waiting for the signal. The foul is on. Jeff Kent inside. Checking in for the first time tonight. Robert Stelmaz of Latvia. HH went to the bench there. I assume it was all on that last three-point shot that he took. Coach was really unhappy and pulled him out of the game. Lawless draws a blank from the first one. Oh, two from the line for Lawless. 4 minutes into the game, 5-4. One or two whistles coming from the Turk fans. There are quite a few of them in the house. John White with a pull-up from 17 feet. Milo with the rebound. Away comes Lawless. Lawless has Erdene with him. Good run from Erdene. Traveling violation is called, though, on Haran Erdene. And it's not been a great start by Olkaspor of Istanbul. Here's another look at the turnover from Erdene. Just didn't get it down in time. He might have been harshly done by the official on that one. But it's forced Didin into a timeout. His side trail after 4 minutes, 5 points to 4. They come from far and wide. Newcastle coach on the right, Tony Garbaletto. Chris Finch on the left. And just behind them, a former London Towers captain, a man who's lifted many a trophy in the black and gold of London Towers, Roger Dehaney. To the Orca fans as well. At the end of the third quarter, Zalgiris are beating Kinder 66 points to 50. At the end of the third. Well, there's a shooting in the opening 4 minutes of play. You can see that neither coach will be overly pleased with the percentages, but perhaps David Lindstrom pleased that his side are at least taking more shots than their visitors, which means potentially they're playing a bit better defense. You can see Coach Didin still talking to his team from the sideline, trying to spot them into life, and they are coming with some full court pressure now. No problems in the end for Chung getting it across the halfway line. Kent fires up a three off the back of the ring. Hickey going after it, but Lawless beat him to it. Away comes Erdene. Skip pass around to Golovic, inside to LA. LA backing down on Hickey, going strong, nice move, then had to fall away to get the shot off. Hickey with the board, oh, he threw it to where Eppenheimer was going, he changed his mind. Erdene toes the line, that one's worth two. And he lit Peristeri up for 34 last week. They'll have to watch out for him. Have a look there, just foot on the line. Hickey to Chung. Oh, Chung throws it away. It's two unforced errors in quick succession by the London Towers. And it was something that Coach David Lindstrom isn't too pleased about. Just a minute after he was speaking to his players during the Turks timeout, he's called one of his own. 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. It's 5-6. Timeout called. Well, David Lindstrom sends his men back out. And they'll be on defensive duties immediately. As Stelmeyer brings it forward. Doljevic inside to Ile. And he knocks it out for two. Chong to Kent Hickey. Give him plenty of room if he wants to think about a shot. Doesn't though. Shot clock now down into the last 6 seconds. Eppenheim has got a look to go. He does. Draws the foul. Shot doesn't go. Foul is called first on it's Stelmeyer's. His first. Just leaning into Eppenheim. A foul is adjudged to have been before the shot, so it'll be an end line ball to the London Towers. It's lobbed into Hickey. Hickey with the catch and lay-in. Oh, he missed it. Gets his own boards, though, and he's fouled, and two in quick succession from Stelmeyer's. Only two fouls on his team, both of them caught against him, and he's in some foul trouble in the opening minute of the game, a few minutes of the game. Hickey gets his first point of the game. Short on the second, it'll come all the way out to him with some help from Jeff Kent. Eppenheimer to Kent. Kent wide open for three off the back of the ring. White is underneath to get the rebound, but he got there by an illegal method, said the referee on the baseline. That is the first foul on John White. Stelmeyer's bringing it forward, hands over to Golovic. Lawless, LA on the baseline. Running along the baseline is Stelmeyer's. Tacks inside, skips it about, good ball movement. Golovic trying to get his shot off and does. Miljan Golovic gets his opening score of the game. And that is five different scorers in their 10 points for Orkutspor. Chung to Kent, inside to Hickey, and there's a foul on the pass in. William Ellie called for his first foul of the game. Robert Youngblood will check into the game for the first time for the London Towers. Phil Hickey getting himself a well-earned breather. Four boards and a point in the early going for the big man. John White going along the baseline. White strong to the hole, tipped away by Lawless. He hands over to Erdene. Getting it back inside to Lawless. Lawless backing down on Youngblood, trying to lob it to Ellie. Ellie inside, got tap fouled. I think it might be White, could be Kent, but I think it was White. Smile on his face there. He wasn't too pleased with either of the two fouls that have been called him on him. Here's another look. It was a good feed first off, and White made very little contact, if any at all, but it's one of those big swoopy slaps that referees do often call if they see it. And John White now forced to the bench. Ronnie Baker in for the first time. William Alley makes his first. But misses the second. Jeff Kent with the board. Epperheimer throws it away, trying to get it to Chung, but couldn't throw it over Golovic. Erdenay forward to Lawless. Oh, beautiful pass from Lawless. I mean, it was so good that I think caught Stelmaz out of sync, and eventually they do get 2 points out of it with William Alley sticking it in. But really, Stelmaz should have put that one away on the first fast break. Ulker opening up a 7-point lead now. Youngblood, strong to the basket, just doesn't get the bobble on that one. Silas Chung chased it down. It'll be out of bounds for Ulker ball. Everybody's run away and left the inbound. Ellie eventually steps back. Erdenay has it up top, lobbed it into Stelmaz, who did well to catch it considering he wasn't looking at the ball when it came at him. Golovic, Erdenay runs off two screens, then fires up for three. That was way short, almost caught by Lawless. Eventually two Turks collide, away come the Towers. Epperheimer to the finger roll, nice move from Brett Epperheimer. And he has 7 of his team's 8 points. Here's another look. Watch Epperheimer, he had to get around his man and finish off with a nice lane in the end. Golovic to the fall away is short. It falls down into the hands of Quadra Lawless, and he lays it back in. Inside 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Youngblood for the Towers. Kent for three. Finally, Jeff Kent gets one to go. They've left him open out there on 3 occasions, and he gets the third one to go. Trims it back to a 4-point ball game. Erdenay, leading scorer on his team in the EuroLeague this year. Stelmaz, nice step under, and there's a little push and shove between he and Ronnie Baker, but play continues. Stelmaz now the 6th man on his team to get on the score sheet here in the first quarter. Nice backdoor cut from Epperheimer, the pass just a little bit ahead of him. Away comes Lawless. Lawless to the finger roll. Kent got a piece of it, but got a piece of his arm as well. Foul is called on Jeff Kent. Make that number 2 on him. Towers have only had 5 fouls in this first quarter, but it's cost them dear because that's 2 fouls on him. Again, another one of those slaps. And 2 fouls on John White as well. Both of them going to the bench now. Stuart Robbins sees some early action here.
Stuart Robbins in for the foul.
Quadra Lawless makes them both. Youngblood brings it over the line, hands over to Chung. Back out to Youngblood. Epperheimer trying to cut back door. Stelmaz was too wise to it. Epperheimer comes out to the corner. Epperheimer for 3. Brett Epperheimer with 10 first quarter points has carried the Towers through this period. The rest of his team have only mustered 4, but Epperheimer with his 2nd 3 of the night has 10. Stelmaz to Lawless along the baseline, and I think Lawless stepped out of bounds. Did he? Referee pointed at the line like he was saying it was out of bounds, but he's eventually come to the table and called a foul on Robert Youngblood, his first. Here's another look. Youngblood not in the greatest defensive position. And you see the way Youngblood nodded at the referee as if to say, yeah, he stepped out of bounds. He hadn't, and the foul was called against Blood. Lawless is his team's leading scorer with 7. Off the back of the ring, Chung tips it to Baker. Towers can run down most of the remaining 20-odd seconds of the first quarter. There's about a 4.5-second difference between game and shot clock. Eppenheimer, ooh, Baker did well to catch that. Inside to Robbins. Robbins to Little Hook, not enough on it. Lawless with the rebound. 10 seconds to go in the first. Lawless to Stelmaz. Stelmaz backs out, has a look at the clock. He'll see 5 on it. Shoots up a deep three, short, rebound, oh, who is boxing out inside? Milan Golovic with the lay-in, no boxing out for the London Towers, a disappointing finish to a otherwise pretty good first quarter. Look, the deep three was always a long way short, but really, Silas Chung should have been the other side of his man to box out. At the end of the first quarter, it is the London Towers, 14, Olkaspor of Istanbul, 22.
Okay, our four contestants are going to do a layup at both ends and then sit cross-legged with the ball in their back. The first one to do it is the winner. So we've got Sam and Becky, Gary and Nick. If you're ready, ladies and gentlemen, pick somebody and cheer them on. You're ready? 3, 2, 1. Well, on adjudication, Phil Gray has awarded Sam to be the winner.
He put a shoes
on that one. The little yellow flag will be run up the pole. Where does he get his ideas from?
You think he's got a little cushion for someone?
I reckon he has. Very strange. So, end of the first quarter, Towers down 14 to 22.
It's the shooting stats there for the first quarter. London Towers not doing a great job in the shooting percentages, but Olka yet to hit from three-point land in 5 attempts. Rest of the stats pretty even, except Towers need to look after the ball a little bit better. We're ready to go just about for the second quarter. And Olkaspor, under these EuroLeague rules, will start the second quarter with the ball. Lawless. Golovic. Golovic's shot is short. Youngblood going after it. Tipped it out to Baker. Nice feed from Baker to Chung. Youngblood. Robbins. Baker offered the screen to Chung. Chung to little floating left. Too much on that one. Rebound from Gonlum into the game for the first time. Erdene kicks it forward. Good fast break. On the end of it was Golovic. He profited with the points, but you could have almost had two assists there for those two beautiful passes. 10-point lead now for the visitors. Eppenheim, a deep three, short. Oh, it bounced over Youngblood's head. Away comes Stelmaz, kicks it forward to Erdene. Erdene will pull up for three, count it. On the fast break, Haron Erdene. That's a tough one to guard, but it's opened up a 13-point Olka lead. Eppenheimer in trouble. Needs some help, finds it in the shape of Baker. Shot clock down to 3. Youngblood doesn't see it. It's going to be a violation. Youngblood, did he get it off in time? No, says the official. A 24-second violation against the London Towers. Tough to blame Youngblood on that one. He was on the sideline. The 24-second clock is above the basket, so he might not have been able to see it properly, but his teammate sure would have. Golovic to Erdene. And Erdene's starting to heat up a little here in the opening minute or two of the second quarter. 34 in Greece last year for the 33-year-old Turk. Eppenheimer driving into the basket. No basket would have counted if it had gone in. The foul was called on Robert Stelmars, and that is his third personal foul. Only four fouls have been called against his team in the whole game. Three of them have been on him. Mustafa Abi will check in for him.
Mustafa Abi.
And you fancy the Latvian won't be seen again now until, well, at least the third quarter on three fouls. White lobs in. Ken to White. Hickey offers the screen. It might have been a moving one. Referee, no call on it. And Hickey backing down draws the foul from Miljan Golubic. Baker for three, flying over Erdene. The ball bounces off the back of the ring all the way out to Erdene. Golubic. Lolas up top. Grunlum. Golubic. Golubic fires up. Doesn't go. Lolas with the athletic rebound and stick back. Every now and then you just think Tower's missing an assignment defensively. Don't box out. And you end up with things like that. And then compound an error. Ronnie Baker threw a pass that really only his coach was going to catch along the sideline. And Towers really haven't looked 17 points worse than Olker in these opening 13 minutes. It's just one or two little errors in the last few minutes have been well punished by the Turkish champions. Three doesn't go from Golovic. Baker forward to Eppenheimer. Eppenheimer strong to the hole. Gets his own rebound after Lawless fails to come down with what should have been his rebound. Kent lobs into Hickey. Hickey's pass is batted away, and it's a little bit behind Abby. Question of backcourt. Referee said no, doesn't matter anyway, as Olkerspor throw the ball away. And really, Dave Lindstrom calling a timeout now after this turnover by the Turks. But as I say, London Towers haven't done that badly in this opening 3 minutes of the second quarter, but it just seems to have all fallen away from them in the last couple of minutes, and out of nowhere they trail by 17.
Final score for Towers. Zalgiris 91, Kinder 67. So the biggest shock of the year so far in EuroLeague. After losing by one to Opel Frankfurt last week, Kinder have lost two games in a row. They lose to Zalgiris 91-67 in Kaunas.
Well, that stat in itself tells a story. Three Towers scorers, two of them combining for 4 points. And then you look how heavily weighted the point spread is among the Olka players. And that really has been the difference. That and the fact that the London Towers have yet to score here in this second quarter. We've played 3 minutes and almost 30 seconds. And you just can't have spells without scoring in this league. Eppenheimer to little floater. That one still doesn't go. Erdene, chance to add to the current 9-0 burst they're on. It's 11-0 if you count that last shot of the first quarter where they should have boxed out the Towers on the buzzer. Lawless. Erdene for three is short. Hickey, oh! Unforced errors. And that, as a coach, you can't legislate for. There's not a lot you can do about your big man going after a board and just bouncing it off his own knee out of bounds. Abby to Golovic. Gonlam in the middle, lobbed into Lawless, tipped up in the air. Lawless can only tap it out of bounds. Kent looking for somebody to get into, eventually finds Baker. White, Hickey, backing down his man. Hickey to the turnaround, that one doesn't go. Lawless tips it away, Abby comes down with the board. Golovic, Erdene. Play being set up now by the Turkish side. They got 8 seconds on the shot clock. Erdene, shot goes up from Gonlum. Bubbles out, Hickey with the rebound. No score for either side in the last couple of minutes. John White with a spin at the halfway line. Still White's going, and the foul is called on Milan Golovic. Number two on him. Ellie will check into the game. And Davor Tomic checking into the game for the first time. Here's another look, a nice spin move at the halfway line from White. Little crossover before he's drawn the foul. John White spins, White finally just under 5 minutes into the second quarter, and the London Towers get their first score of the period off this spin move from John White. It is his first score of the game, and they gave up 11 straight, and that really is why they're 15 down now. Erdene with the tougher fall away. Ellie beat his man to the rebound, but then stepped out of bounds. Big screen from Hickey at the halfway line. White still going, attacking the basket, and the foul was called.
Another foul.
It's the second on William Ellie. Stellmeyer's, I said we wouldn't see him to the third quarter. Coach Didin has different ideas to me, because he's just put him back out on the game. Number seven, who's on three fouls. Tomic. White spinning both ways. White, nice move. Not quite enough juice on the shot. Hickey can only tip it out of bounds. Here's a look. See White going both ways. Saw the help from Elliot. Really, that's the sort of shot you would expect John White to make. And in this league, Towers need John White to make. Erdene. Lob pass round to the far side, and Abby attacking the basket. Whistle on the play, and that is a foul on John White. And just when he looked like he might be starting to get into the game a little bit, John White goes to the bench with fouls. Does he know? He's on three, but the coach decides to take Hickey and Eppenheimer out instead. So White's got to watch himself with 4 minutes to go to halftime on three fouls. Ellie wants it. He's going against Youngblood. He's got the height advantage, and he takes full advantage on that occasion. Youngblood trying to go back, right back at him. He does, but Youngblood can't convert. Davor Tomic plays for the Towers, only in the EuroLeague, gets the board. Kent trying to get it inside, a sloppy pass, and Towers were lucky to come away with possession out of that one. Eppenheimer will come into the game now for John White. Had to really go to the bench. 3:33 to go in the first half. John White on three fouls, taking a breather. It's 33-16, a lot of threes about. Look at Eppenheimer trying to get away from Abby. Although I'm not sure whether Eppenheimer was hooking Abby there, trying to get a foul. Eppenheimer now for three. That one is short. Tomic going after the rebound. Did a good job to knock the ball loose. Eventually comes up with it, in with the big trees, and it was tipped out of bounds by Gonlum. There appears to be a reset of the shot clock. I don't think it would have mattered much. There shouldn't have been, but perhaps only a second or two in it. Good pass. Oh, Youngblood, how'd he miss that from close in? The Turk fans enjoying that close-in miss from Robert Youngblood. Suffice to say, the former Leopard and now Tower didn't. Ellie backing down. Ellie wants to go against whoever's guarding him, whether it be Youngblood, whether it be Kent, whether it be Hickey. He's happy enough with his back to the basket on the blocks to go right at him, and that is foul number three on Jeff Kent. London Towers have only had eight fouls called against them in the whole game. Unfortunately, three of them have been on John White and three of them have been on Jeff Kent. And it means Stuart Robbins now has got to come in, and another London Towers starter going to the bench in foul trouble. There's the numbers on Ellie's evening so far, 7.7 boards. Draws a blank on the first free throw. Graduate of Southeastern Missouri State University a couple of years ago. Tomic. Trying to get it to Robbins. In the end, had to go to Youngblood. Body's hitting the deck, no whistles. Away come the Turks again at speed, but you've got to put the ball down. Out on the fast break, Stelmas just didn't dribble it. Kept on running, but a little bit late putting the ball to the floor. Here's another look, which he catches the ball there. Yeah, well, I suppose that might have been a touch harsh on him, but referee was right on the spot. And Abby and Eppenheimer have been in close contact for the last couple of minutes. And finally, Brett Eppenheimer gets what he wants. And that's a foul on Mustafa Abby. Well, Okushpor over the limit, so it'll be a couple of free throws for Brett Eppenheimer at 10 first quarter points. That, with 2:37 to go to halftime, is his first point of the second period. But he's had very little help from the remainder of his team. He has 12, the Towers have 18, so he's more than double, well, he's exactly double what the rest of his team has contributed. Tomic comes up with the loose ball. Eppenheimer, oh, right through his own hands, and the foul was called. Coach Murat Didin calling for a timeout there after his team turned the ball over. He might have wanted to cancel it after Eppenheimer lost it out of bounds, but it was too late by that stage. 2:29 to go in the first half. London Towers 18, Okushpor of Istanbul 33. Well, that's definitely not Jason Kimber waving the Okushpor flag, I'm sure. Although you never know with these Leopards players, there is some rivalry between the Towers and the Leopards, but that's definitely a Turk fan in front of him waving the Okushpor flag. And they've turned out in their numbers, and they all seem to have brought a flag with them. That's the program for today's game. Zalgiris, with the shock of the season, have already defeated Kinder in an unbelievable result. Kinder Bologna, the former European champions, beaten by Zalgiris, themselves former European champions, although not quite the team they were 2 years ago when they won this competition. Lawless had it knocked away, and this is the first time we've seen one or two of these players since the start of the game. And in the corner was Milan Golovic. Erdenade with the assist, and Eppenheimer trying to reply for three, doesn't go. Golovic with the rebound. Acic to Erdenade. Acic has seen a lot of bench action since that air ball three. Coach getting his point across, I think. Ball loose on the floor, Hickey going down for it, but it was Ellie who touched it last. He batted it out of bounds, though, so it's a London Towers ball. There's a... That was a tough pass thrown right off the leg, ball loose on the floor, and tough to see who touched it last, but Ellie was certainly diving in that way. You see Ulkespor not shooting very well from behind the three-point line. Neither, it must be said, are the London Towers. Chung to Hickey. Tomic. Hickey fires up. Nice shot from Phil Hickey. Seconds to go in the first half. Quadra Lawless up top for Ulker of Istanbul. Erdenay looking to shake and bake. Gets himself a little bit of room. He loves that little, he just has a little fade on his shot. Not quite a fall away, but a bit of a fade. Pretty effective though. Here's another look. Watch him just sort of fade away just a little bit. Nice spin from Thomas, still trying to find his way to the basket. In the end, he ran into the big trees with no momentum. Erdenay backs out. LA offers the screen. Now he goes on to the blocks, but the pass can't get there. Lawless hands over to Golovic. His three doesn't go. Akic with the rebound. Erdenay. Rebounding fell even in the game. Towers done a good job on the boards. Just not done too great a job at putting the ball in the hole. Golubic, five on the clock. Great block. It's a goaltend, though, says the referee. Phil Hickey didn't quite get there in time. Ball just on its way down. 5 seconds to go to halftime. That's another look. Eppenheimer throws it from the halfway line off the backboard, and it doesn't go. And really, the disappointing start to the second quarter has been the difference in the game so far. At the half, it is Kinder London Towers 20, Ulkespor of Istanbul in Turkey 40.
Yeah. Horrific, isn't it? Sorry, about what they scored, six in the second quarter?
Yeah. They gave up. I only had 11.
When we take on the Thames Valley Tigers, at a 6 o'clock start, and that'll be our last game of the year 2001.
Well, the key thing to that stat is the one right in the middle there. London Towers 4 of 18 from inside the paint. That will hurt, especially compared to 13 of 21. Doesn't matter if you don't shoot the 3 too well. If you can pound it down inside and shoot at that sort of clip, you should be all right.
Over the house of Cooper Sewell.
Well, David Lindstrom sends his troops out for the second half, knowing really the hole that his team has dug is all of their own doing. They are down 20 at halftime, mainly from hustle plays. Ukush ball will get us off and underway, but really 13 points off 10 London Towers turnovers and 10 points off 9 offensive rebounds. That's 23 points just off hustle from the Turks in the first half. That is the difference in the game. Erdene stepping in and underneath. That man's had a little bit to do with it as well. Second player on his team into double figures. Just seems to find a way to get his shot off every time. Eppenheimer. Hickey trying to get open but couldn't, so he offers the screen instead. Eppenheimer with a stutter step and then fires up. Tough shot from Brett Eppenheimer. He has carried his team. Look at this. Little stutter step to get through. Then still had the presence to finish off the play. 14 points for him. 8 points for the rest of his team. Eppenheimer foul number 2. They'll be in real trouble if he gets into any problems with fouls. Ellie. Golovic. Golovic fires short. Comes all the way out to Davor Tomic. Tomic has Robbins with him. Eppenheimer on the far side. He goes to Chung then. Here's Eppenheimer. Fast break opportunity goes for the Towers. Eppenheimer, deep three. Short. Golovic with the rebound. Tomic tried to knock it loose but couldn't. Away comes Stelmeyer. Throws it long to Lawless. Lawless with the head fake. Oh, what a pass from Lawless. Sent Hickey and Robbins up in the air thinking shot, but he found William Elliott along the baseline. He laid it in. Watch this play. That's a pretty good pass, but look at this one. Goes up. Whoa. And there they are to finish. Stelmeyer, and there is a couple more points off London Towers turnovers. And that has been a big blow for the home team. Chung with the crossover to Eppenheimer in the corner. Stelmeyer hits the deck. It came off his foot. Referee says, get up. Nothing wrong with that play. Here's another look. There was some collision, but he was definitely looking for the foul. Ronnie Baker into the game for the first time in the second half. Robbins. Robbins going strong. Was almost looking to pass it. I think that's why he missed the lane, because he wasn't expecting to take it. Nice bounce pass to Golovic, who is fouled by Silas Chung. Stelmeyer with the what would have been an assist. There's a look. There's a great bounce pass. And Silas Chung just making sure he's going to have to earn his points from the line. Milan Golovic. Slovenian national Golovic makes them both, and he is the leading scorer on his team. Hickey. Robbins, Ronnie Baker, Eppenheimer. Eppenheimer's shot is short. Hickey knocks it loose, and Silas Chung picks up the pieces. Hickey, Robbins. Skip pass to Baker inside. Good hands from Ellie to knock it loose. Long pass from Stelmeyer through the hands of Ali, saves it. Oh, and it comes all the way to Lawless. Good play. Golovic. And Stelmeyer backs out. 10 seconds left on this offense. Lawless. Lawless with the three. Air ball. Nasty looking shot from Lawless. They get it off in time. Stellamage with two on the shot clock after the air ball from Lawless. There's the air ball. Stellamage heads up play. He had to get that shot off because the ball never hit the ring. So there was no reset of the shot clock. And having given up something like 17 in a row in the first half, Cows haven't exactly come out of the blocks here in the second. They trail 10-2 in this period. Chunk for three, count it. The shot clock buzzer went off, but the ball was out of his hands. So that one is good for three. Chung gets it off. The buzzer went there. You can see it's zero, but as long as it goes in, it counts. Walker out scoring the Towers 2-1 and have done pretty much since early in the second quarter. Ellie Golovic, traveling violation called on Milan Golovic. You can see Towers committing more turnovers, but more worryingly for the London Towers, it's the points that Ulker have managed to put on at the other end when Towers do cough it up. They are averaging more than a point a turnover, which is always good numbers, and any coach would be pleased to see it. Foul is called on William Early, trying to deny the ball into Phil Hickey, pushing foul on him. That's number three. Lobbed into Hickey, but he wasn't ready for it. Oh, Erdene just trying to get away on the fast break, could only get a fingertip to it, and in the end it went out of bounds off him. It's been a tough baptism of fire for David Lindstrom. First of all, he's had to cope with four games in a week, and the Towers have struggled in them. Eppenheimer to the basket, looking for a call, not getting one. Stellamage to Erdene, wide open. Oh, but he missed it. Golovic was fouled on the rebound by Phil Hickey. Only number one on him, but it will send Golovic to the line. Gorjevic knocks him out. Now becomes the game's leading scorer. And you can see Ulker getting to the line a lot more than the London Towers. That's partly because they attack the ball a bit more, basket a bit more. Golovic waiting for some trail. Here it comes in the shape of Erdene inside to Ellie. Oh, nice. Very nice. Oh, but he missed the lay-in. Some good ball movement from Erdene to Ellie to Lawless, but Lawless couldn't make the lay-in. Eppenheimer in problems. Baker for three. Yes, Ronnie Baker knocks it out. There's a look. Textbook three-point shot from Ronnie Baker. Stelmaz. Erdene has it inside to Ellie. Oh, blocked by Robbins. And that is a goaltend. And you know what? I don't think it was going in either. But unfortunately, it doesn't matter. If it's on the way down, it is a goaltend. Have another look. I'm not sure this one was going over the ring. As Robbins comes, tough to say, but I don't think that shot was going in. But it will count for two. Chung for three, off the back of the ring. Robbins, can he chase it down? No, he can't, because Golovic will beat him to it and throw it forward to Lawless. Lawless with the catch is fouled from behind by Ronnie Baker. In fact, coming from the big boys inside. Lawless becomes the fourth man on his team into double figures. Oh, sloppy play once again from the London Towers. And when he watches the tape back, David Lindstrom, he'll be pointing out the errors that his own team has made, because that has been really the principal factor for the London Towers. Yes, they haven't scored enough points to be in the game, but they really have shot themselves in the foot. Eppenheimer for three is perhaps the only man who will look back on tonight as a decent night offensively. 17 points for him, 14 for the rest of his team. Stanimars gets it to Golovic on the far side. Ellie looking to go to work on Robbins this time. He's back down Youngblood, he's back down Hickey, he's back down Kent. So he might as well have a go against Stuart Robbins. And eventually Robbins, as was the case with the other three, commits a foul and sends the big man to the line. Played last year for Besiktas, also in Istanbul, before moving in the summer to Ulka. And another offensive rebound and a chance for some more second chance points, which they've had a lot of so far tonight. And third chance points here from Lawless with the stick back. Eppenheimer to Chung. Got slightly deflected, but Chung still found Hickey with a behind-the-back pass, and Hickey becomes the second highest scorer on the London Towers team with five. Nice behind-the-back pass from Chung. Lawless. Golovic for three. He's the game's leading scorer now with 18. Chung inside to Robbins. Robbins spinning through and was fouled by William Ellie from behind. And that is the fourth foul on the big man. His coach hasn't immediately gone to the bench. He's got one or two guys warming up along the baseline like footballers almost. Stuart Robbins. First point of the game. The Towers have had seven different players contribute in terms of offense. Unfortunately, beyond Brett Eppenheimer, none of the contributions have been that notable. Oh, nice. Golovic is at the end to lay it in. The assist from Lawless. And also an honorable mention for the down-court pass from Ellie. And Gula, who came into the game for the first time a few moments ago, also with a nice pass involved. Chung, head fake, backs out, tried to get back behind the line, couldn't quite do it. That was worth two. Stanimars, Golovic. Lawless trying to clear out, as he knows he's getting the ball to Stanimars. Hello, backing in, that one's short. Lawless gets his rebound though, that one is short as well. Tipped up by Robbins, rebound Hickey, away comes Chung for the London Towers. Chung to Robbins, Robbins, that's never a travel. That is never a travel. It's been called though. That's the fourth traveling violation of the game, and I have to say, each one of them has been harsh. I think there were two on each team. Here's another look. One, two, that's a catch and layup, I'm afraid. Doesn't matter whether he's got the ball under control. You're allowed two steps before a lane. Golovic to Lawless. And the Turkish fans are starting to celebrate early. They're up and they're singing, their flags are waving, they're dancing. One or two of them blowing whistles, which they're not allowed to do. They've been warned. because it does sound a little bit too much like the official's whistle. There's a guilty party right there. In the midst of all the joyity, Ellie has been sent to the line. Kind roll on the second. Baker looking to show his speed against Gullah, and Gullah did a good job defensively until he reached in. He had him going nowhere along the baseline. He just needed to perhaps step back. But instead he chose to reach in and was called for the foul. Came through the youth program at Old Cushball. Baker in the corner. Second three of the night for Ronnie Baker. Away comes Silas Chung. Epperheimer, four on the third quarter clock, gets the shot off just in time, and Brett Epperheimer continues to lead the London Towers. He has 19 of his team's 42 points. Unfortunately, the rest of his team hasn't contributed too much. And at the end of three, it is the London Towers 42, Olkuspor of Istanbul 67. There's the shooting stats in the game so far, and you can really see the difference there in the 2 points, 30% difference. They've taken so many more shots as well. The rebounding, they've done a great job of working on their offensive boards to put back in for easy scores, Ulka. And the turnovers, the 16 turnovers by the London Towers, has also cost them dearly.
I've got one layup to set. Right, I'm going to come back. Right, that's it. We've got two now. Straight up the other end. And yeah, we've got it again. Okay, 2-1, we've got that. Now, we're going back up here. Is that going to be 3-3? This guy's got plenty to serve. They've got good technique.
There's the leading scorers in the game, and that tells a big story. Four guys in double figures for Ulka, and just the one for the London Towers. Lawless has really belied his height, dominating the boards as he has. But really, Towers haven't done that bad on the rebounding. They've just not done a very good job of ensuring that Ulka don't get too many second chance opportunities. Well, London Towers did at least win the jump ball at the beginning of the game, so therefore they will get the possession for the final quarter. Or at least they will do, but the table is blowing the horn because the clock hasn't started. Nobody realized, whether they thought that was the Ulka fans blowing horns, but the table wasn't ready for the start of the fourth quarter. But the stats that really leap out in this game so far, Ulka with 19 points off London Towers turnovers, 19-4. And second chance points, well, Ulka dominating that 18-1. So through three quarters, Ulka really have dominated. Here we go then with the fourth quarter. Silas Chung. Jeff Kent. Youngblood. Epperheimer up top to White. Sat the whole of the third quarter, John White, in the last 3 minutes. So comes off the bench cold, but still gets a three off and is fouled by Milan Golovic, his third.
Third foul on Milan Golovic. John White at the line.
John White makes the first of his three free throws. to a two. That doubles John White's points total for the game, and that in itself tells the story, especially given the absence of Terrell Myers through the injury. I think David Lindstrom will be a bit disappointed the way his team have come out here tonight. He must have fancied them. 8 second violation, is it? Yeah, an 8 second violation. That was good defense by the London Towers, stopping the Turks from getting across the halfway line in time. But David Lindstrom would have been hoping for good things from his London Towers team tonight, having had a good few days in practice, but that stat has killed them. 17 turnovers by the London Towers. Ulker have profited with 18 points from those 17 turnovers. Epperheimer, nice pass inside to Youngblood. Youngblood misses again from close in. White, tough shot, and he's fouled in the process. The foul is on Asim Pars. Epperheimer, you see, this is where Youngblood's got to score that. White with the fall away, three men on him. Somebody got him, so John White again will go to the foul line.
On the technicians for the commentary table, please. Immediately.
Just a bit of a problem with the shot clock. Seems to have gone down. That's foul trouble in the game. Not really going to make much of a difference, I wouldn't have thought, here in these final 9 minutes, even though William Ellie has had a great game. I don't think Ulka need him that much in these last few minutes. He's already sat on the bench. Be surprised if we see him again. John White now with 7 points becomes the second leading scorer on his team, and he scored five of them in the last 30 seconds. It shows you the problems offensively the Towers have had, Epperheimer aside. Pause managed to get his own rebounder. Pause trying to lob it inside to Pashula, who lays it in. Zaru Pashulia with Zaza on his back, just in case you're wondering. John White might have got a little bump there. Certainly did from Goljevic, fourth foul. So they've got Goljevic and Ilay, they're two starters, they're two leading scorers, both on four fouls, but still don't think Coach Didden will be too concerned. Not with the 22-point lead, anyway. You never know, though. Asim Pars with the rebound. Silas Chung is called for one there. His second.
Scores from various groups. Scavellini leading all roll at half-time, 52-43. At the end of the third, Ostender beating Partizan Belgrade.
Goljevic fires up for three, and there's a foul called inside. The foul was on Asim Pars. The three will count for Milan Goljevic. He's got 23. Here's another look at the three.
Skipper Bologna, 46. Panathinaikos, 39.
Eppenheimer. Eppenheimer trying to beat his man to the baseline and did, and the foul was called on Mustafa Abi. His second team over the limit, so it should be a couple. There's another look at the foul. Eppenheimer with the pace. And yes, the referees have realized it will be two shots for Eppenheimer. That's Eppenheimer's numbers on the night. That's his first miss from the foul line. 4-9 and 3-9. Too bad shooting, but offensively he has totally carried his team. He's got 19 points. Gula for three, yes! First score of the night for Murukan Güler. Eppenheimer having to go a long way into the backcourt to get the ball. Now looking to go to work against Abby. To Ken. Ken for three short. White going after it, as his Youngblood neither came up with it. Goljevic did. Pause. In fact, it was a traveling violation called on Gula. It was Abby rather than Pause who gave the ball to him.
Sunday afternoon at 5 o'clock, the Towers taking on the Milton Keynes Lions in the BBL Trophy.
But Eppenheimer gets it to Silas Chung.
It's good away to Chung.
Still Chung to Eppenheimer. White wants it on the blocks. Youngblood's there as well. Eppenheimer attacking the basket. Fires up the shot. Might get a kind bounce and does. And well, he deserves it.
21 for Brett Eppenheimer.
Goljevic to Pars. Skipped on to Pasula. Abby for three. Tipped up in the air. Pause is there to stick it back. And Youngblood had hold of his shirt at the same time. Youngblood is called for the foul. And as in Pars, becomes the eighth player on his team to get on the score sheet. It was his shorts that Youngblood, in fact, had hold of. Hickey couldn't quite chase down the pass from John White. 6:47 to go in the game. London Towers trailing 49-78. To Ulkuspor from Istanbul. Abi. Abi, oh, nice move to the basket. Just about bobbles. Had a good think. And he's now on the score sheet. Just three guys on the roster yet to score now. White for three short. Hickey knocks it out to Chung. Chung has to go from 3 point land and hits.
8 points for Silas Chung.
2 of 4 from downtown for Silas Chung this evening. Abi. Goljevic back to Abi. Abi with the big long step through the middle. It was a hack across his chest. Up top, and it was on Ronnie Baker. I think that might have been before the shot, so it could well be possession. But we'll find that out in a minute's time, because first of all, there's a timeout called by David Lindstrom with 5:52 to go in the game. His team trail 52 points to 80.
It's the bubbles first.
Berlin. Maccabi Tel Aviv have beat Alba Berlin 64-65. So Alba Berlin lose at home to Maccabi Tel Aviv.
Well, Abby will be given a couple of shots. And he'll make them both. Still coming with some up-court pressure, mainly through the youngster here, Gola. White. Ronnie Baker coming around the screen, gets it to Chung. Hickey wants it inside. Chung doesn't need him because he goes alone for a couple. Silas Chung with five in a hurry to take him up to 10 points. First London Towers player other than Brett Eppheimer to hit double figures, and we have just over 5 minutes to go in the fourth. That has been a huge problem for the London Towers, the lack of support offensively for Brett Eppheimer. Ronnie Baker is called for his third foul of the game. And Coach Didin of Ulkar Istanbul has now called a timeout with 5:15 to go, 54-82 the score. Towers have managed to get 10 two-point shots to go in here, but you can see that's 15 less than their opponents, and that has been a huge problem, just putting the ball in the basket, let alone the 17 turnovers that the Towers have given up in the game, which has really stung them. They've been run back very vigorously by the Turks, and they've scored virtually on every other one, and you can see it's easy to know why the Turkish fans are celebrating, and celebrating early. They've been singing and dancing here in some number, although not quite the intimidatory figures there were in Turkey when these two teams met at the beginning of the EuroLeague campaign. 4,000 Turks crammed in, screaming for their team for victory. Not quite that many here today, but they should get the same result. Golovic will almost certainly finish up the game's leading scorer. Certainly his team's leading scorer. He leads all with 25 at the moment. Only Eppheimer surely can catch him. Hickey is called for an offensive foul. Asim Paz hit the deck. Hickey there just turned to his coach and said he flopped. It's not how the referee saw it. Foul number three. Gula Golovic gets it inside to Pishulia, stumbling through the middle, and there is a foul called on Phil Hickey, two in quick succession, and he has just a look on his face like, what I gotta do, coach? Here's another look. Well, make your own mind up on that one, I think. 4:41 to go. Yet another timeout called out by Ulker, despite the fact they lead the game by 30.
Trying to get the second team to run.
the point spread starting to look a little more balanced for the London Towers, but it's too little too late to get your second man into double figures with 5 minutes of the game still to go and only have two in double figures, four the other way. Golovic has really been the most influential player. Adonai did his work early on. Ely liked his matchup, whoever he was facing, and Lawless has done some good work on the boards, as that stat confirms. But really, Lawless and Ely have been noticeable by their absence here in the last few minutes. And Turkish coach Didin really trying to get his bench players to perform a role here. The only starter he's got on court at the minute is Milan Golovic. Zarur Pashulia at the line. Zaza, as you can probably read on his shirt, as he is known. Jung to Kent. Youngblood. White. Inside for an easy lay-in. It was good offense, this, from the London Towers, and White had the patience to wait till he got the right side of the hoop to score. Güler up top. 30-point lead for the Turks. Pass. Too much on it. Rebound, Jeff Kent. Kent with the backdoor pass to Silas Chung. All 12 of Silas's points have come in the second half. It was a good cut backdoor by Silas Chung. Some sloppy defense from Güler, to be fair. Golovic to Abi. Azim Pars. Shot clock ticking down now. On Oka, got to look to get it off. It's down to three. Abi throws it out. They're not going to get it off in time. And didn't seem anybody on the team notice the shot clock running out on them. And eventually the 24-second Huda went off. Gulo was the last man holding the ball. Chung. Chung for three, doesn't go. Azim Pars with the rebound.
Pars with the rebound,
Golovic to Güler. Abi gets it inside to Azim Pars. Pars, step under, nice step under it was too, and there was a foul called. It's either Youngblood or White, they both went after him. I think it might be Youngblood, yes it is, says the referee. His third personal. Stelmars and Gonlum checking back into the game. Coach has a handshake for Güler and a few words for his young point guard. Abi going to the bench. It isn't Güler sitting down, though. He goes back out onto court. It's Pashula that will sit down. Azim Pars makes the second. David Lindstrom, well, he knows what he has to do now. He's seen his team in action four times. He knows, I'm sure now, where the problems are, and therein lies one of them. They get away there. Might have just got a touch off one of the Turkish players, but they can't afford to cough the ball up, certainly not as often as they have done, and certainly not in this, which is basically the second best league in the world, behind the NBA, the EuroLeague, and Brett Eppenheimer drains a three. His fourth of the night, 40% from behind the arc, good shooting, and they've all been pretty deep. And whilst that three went in, there was a collision between Robert Youngblood of the Towers and Robert Stelmars of Ulker, and that is the fourth foul on both of them. A double foul called in that position. Güler. Conlon. Asim Pars to Golovic. Golovic is high arcing three. Put plenty of air underneath that one. He's determined to keep ahead of Eppenheimer and remain the leading scorer. Robert Youngblood replies at the other end with his first score of the day. We're inside the final two. The London Towers trailing 63-90. Youngblood hits the deck and it's an offensive foul on Asim Pars. Here's another look at the pull-up from John White. John White, incidentally, the third tower into double figures with that one. We got a timeout in the game. 1:54 to go, 63-90 the score. Eppenheimer and Golovic, who have been really the two biggest offensive threats on the night, both hitting four times from behind the arc. Golovic leading all scorers with 28, Eppenheimer leading the Towers by a distance with 24. Still double the next best on his team. Eppenheimer, perhaps his fifth three, yes indeed. 5 of 11 from behind the arc for Brett Eppenheimer. He's got 27. Golovic to Stelamaz, trying to get it inside to Pars, and does. Pars has it ripped away by Silas Chung, but not quite in time to prevent the jump ball. Mustafa Arbi will check back in during this gap. There's the throw inside. Chung doing a great job of wrapping the ball up, and if he could have just pulled it away a little bit quicker, he'd have come up with the steal, but instead it'll be a jump ball. And Asim Pars has roughly 7 inches height advantage over Silas Chung. But Chung wins the jump ball, unbelievably, tips it to John White. White goes up for the finger roll, and the foul is called. What a play from Silas Chung. He had no right in the world to win that jump ball. Have a look at this. Just gets up away from the big man. John White thinks, right, we need a couple of points here to emphasize this one. He'll have to get him from the line, though, because Mardukan Gula committed the foul. John White with 10 fourth quarter points is the equal second leading scorer on his team with 12. Abbey hands over to Gula. Gonlam. Asim Pars and Golovic coming around the screen. Back to Pars, back out to Golovic. Golovic, ooh, he might have got hit by Youngblood after the shot. Referee missed it. Away comes Chung. White wants it on the far side. Doesn't get it, though. Eppenheimer penetrates. Still Eppenheimer. Fires up, and the foul is called. It's on Gular again, his third. And Brett Eppenheimer can finish the game as the leading scorer. He's tied now with 28 with Milan Golovic. And now he takes the lead. Inside the final minute. 21 points down the London Towers. Gonlum to Pars. Pars and John White talking some trash, but play carries on. Gonlum with the fall away. Chung. Youngblood gets it to White. White all on his own for three. Counted for John White. You wonder what happened if he hadn't have got in foul trouble so early on. Pause. 10 seconds to go in the game. Gonlum.
Gonlum.
To Abbey. Abbey going the long way round is fouled by John White. His fourth foul, and he looks like he might have injured himself in the process. Still looks in a little bit of pain, but he won't have to bear it. Oh, that'd be way short. Ugly looking free throw. Won't have to bear it too much long. There are 3.9 seconds to go in the game. And Abbey makes the second. Thrown down court. Silas Chung gets one off on the buzzer. And it goes for the London Towers. Bit of excitement to finish from Silas Chung with the three, but the result was never really in doubt since that second quarter where they scored something like 17 points in a row, Okaspor of Istanbul. They never looked back from that. Towers really struggled. Points off turnovers, second chance points, all being dominated by the Turks. Brett Eppenheimer was really the only offensive threat for the London Towers. Silas Chung and John White had 15 each in the end, but much of that came in the closing few minutes. Eppenheimer had 28 and led his team all the way through the game. For the Turks, Golovic with 28 was helped by countless other of his teammates. And the dream of the next stage is still alive for the Turkish side. After the victory here, it's finished. The Kinder London Towers 75, Ulkaspor of Istanbul 93. Thank you.